Every year, we seem to hear more and more about wildfires. They appear to happen more often and spread quicker. In places like California, wildfires regularly force thousands of people to evacuate their homes. What's going on? And what can we do about it? Wildfires are a terrifying phenomenon. They can burn through anything in their path, and they do so quickly. Wildfires can travel up to 6 miles per hour in forests and up to 14 miles per hour in grasslands. That's faster than a person can run. And they move even faster uphill. We've come up with many different approaches to tackle these blazes. In fact, as strange as it may sound, one way to manage forest fires is to deliberately start them. Sounds pretty risky, right? Well, not if you know what you're doing. In this episode, we'll explore the science of forest fires, why they occur, how climate change is adding fuel to the fire, and how trying to prevent fires can actually make the problem worse. Now, let's get started. Wildfires have always occurred in forests around the world, but now they're getting worse.
This is certainly one of the deadliest wildfires
in Australia.
Firefighters are still battling the worst wildfire in the Mourne Mountains in living memory.
Wildfires are actually a naturally occurring phenomenon and an important part of many forest life cycles. Bolts of lightning can set dry undergrowth ablaze, and occasionally, even hot lava from volcanoes can set fire to forests too. As the undergrowth burns, dry, dead trees are destroyed, while the damp foliage of younger trees protects them from the heat. This process creates space for new trees to grow and enables forests to naturally renew themselves. Now that all makes sense, but wildfires are now growing larger and burning through healthy young trees as well as old dead trees. Now scientists believe there are three main reasons for this. Climate change is causing weather patterns to change. Locations such as California and Australia are already hot and dry. But as their climates turn even hotter and drier, it becomes easier for fires to start burning and then spread further. These fires also destroy more forest ecosystems. Extreme heat is also melting snow and ice in the Arctic Circle. Forest fires are breaking out in areas where they never used to burn, when woodland was protected by cooler temperatures. So basically, the hotter the planet, the more frequent and bigger the fires. A second reason why forest fires are growing is because the condition of many forests is changing. But what does this mean exactly? Well, small fires are part of many forests' natural life cycles. Dead trees and dry leaves form flammable material that easily catch fire. Many communities living near forests, particularly in the past, deliberately started small fires to burn off this material. It's a process called controlled burning. But in recent decades, fire services have extinguished smaller fires to avoid them turning into larger fires. And unfortunately, this has led to a gradual buildup of material that would previously have been burned off. This flammable material acts as the perfect fuel for fires to quickly burn through. So when a forest fire does occur, it can rapidly burn out of control and become too powerful for fire services to tackle. It's a difficult problem, but in order to avoid fires burning, we will need to change the way we manage our forests. Human activity now causes 85% of forest fires. Whether it's through campfires getting out of control or trash igniting, it's us rather than nature that's starting most fires. And in fact, due to the amount of fireworks set off during 4th of July celebrations, it's become the date when most wildfires start across the United States. And because more of us are moving to towns and cities located close to woodland areas, the chances of fires being accidentally started is increasing. And when a forest fire occurs in populated areas, there's a higher chance that people and their property will be caught up in the destruction. As we become better at understanding wildfires, we can take steps to reduce their impact. By limiting levels of greenhouse gases we release into the atmosphere, we can lessen the likelihood of extreme heat waves fueling fires. By managing our forests better, we can ensure dry undergrowth is burned in a controlled way before it can contribute to much larger fires. And by inserting fire breaks or large gaps between trees into our towns and cities, we can make it harder for fires to spread and limit the damage of fires to our communities. Wildfires will always be with us. They're a natural phenomenon and an essential part of healthy forest ecosystems. But we can work to limit the damage that future fires might cause by turning our knowledge of fires into practical action that will help us live alongside them. Thanks for watching, and be sure to subscribe to the channel to see the next episode. We also make weekly science news videos that you can find by signing up to twigsciencereporter.com. See you next time.